I jokingly call the lab or get to play with the toys.
You can try it. You want to write again if you want to.
Because you actually make it do something. It's not pencil and paper. You get to watch and see what's really happening out there versus just all on the computer screen. Let me get started here. We can do the lab online. The equipment can be run remotely, and you can view the results or the equipment working remotely as well, too.
I have to help it along here.
I've been teaching this class for a number of years and knew that we could teach the laboratory portion of it distance because all the equipment is accessible over the internet.
I have started recording, so keep it PG.
Always.
We always are.
What we were doing was basically going in with a program that we had already written and just trying to test out and see if that program worked properly.
So we outfit three stations here that allowed us to teach the three groups of students at the same time.
We weren't able to actually see what we were programming kind of move and operate. So instead, we had cameras that were in the lab already, and we were just able to use those to kind of pan around and see that our machine was doing what we wanted it to do.
One of my TAs is actually in St. Louis, so he remotes in. He has one computer, but a couple of virtual machines on it, so he can join two Zoom meetings.
Yeah, tease it a little more.
There's a little bit of a delay. I don't want to overshoot.
There you go.
You know, if something were to go wrong, then the TA or Dr. Erickson was able to just go in and, you know, fix the machine and like set it back to a default condition.
They have the programming software, they download it to the controller, they can monitor the operation from the PC on the controller, but they also typically work with a small panel. So then you click on the buttons with your mouse and it'd be just like you're at the station in Rolla.
So, how have all your days been?
Good.
It's good. I've been up since lecture, actually.
Oh, wow.
But they seem to be putting a little more serious about it.
And then I upload download. Or download?
No,
yeah, download.
Do not upload. Upload is so danger, confusing. Will Robinson.
They're going beyond what I've typically laid out for them to do. Well, they're putting more effort into it. They're actually doing 2 weeks' worth of work on the first week, is what I noticed. Very good, guys. You're ahead of the game. Biggest change in lab. It's just having to get the technology going. After that, I mean, the interaction is still pretty much the same. I mean, you can pretty much help them with the technologies now as if they were sitting there. We can basically look over their shoulder just like it was in the lab. In fact, it's a little more convenient. With a large monitor, you can see it better than looking over their shoulder.
I think Dr. Erickson was very prepared for the transition to all online. And honestly, for me personally, the transition was very smooth. If any college were to adapt the quickest, it would be S&T, just because of the nature of the students.
I think the students are getting a little more used to, you know, just viewing it just, okay, we're just next to each other, but just not necessarily personally, but we are definitely virtually in the meeting. I mean, obviously they prefer to be in lab, but we try to make it as easy as possible to do it remotely.
Will, you doing okay over there?
We're all done here.